here in Sunrise, Florida, and we got here yesterday, and we've just been acclimating to Florida. It's really hot and really humid. I just want to make a video to kind of note where I'm at right now. So, also, I got my piercings replaced with retainers, they're called. At the piercing place today, I passed completely, and it was really weird. I had to lie on this, like, slightly raised up chair thing so that the guy could get in and replace all the piercings, and I was like, you're really close to me, and you still think I'm male. And I was like, before I lay down, I, like, pulled the binder to make sure it was as flat as I could get it, and it was fine, no problem. It was just weird, and I'm working on how to move through the world as someone who's perceived as male. So I'll put that in my next big update video, too. My parents and I got to have a conversation about how we're all feeling, what we're excited about, what we're nervous about, what we're looking forward to, what we don't know is going to happen, things like that. Really good conversation. My mom feels good. My dad is worried that I'm going to be in pain. Basically, where I'm at right now is I keep fluctuating between excitement and anxiety and euphoria and fear. And, I think this is pretty standard. I decided that I'm really scared to get up on the operating table. I think I'm going to have to do that. But I decided that instead of being scared of that, that's my moment to, like, really be brave and to be like, this is what I want, and I'm gonna get it right now. But other than that, I'm not so scared of the pain. I have good feelings about liquid Vicodin, and I feel pretty prepared. I know step by step pretty much what's gonna happen. I have my pre-op appointment with him tomorrow at 3. And then surgery the next day at noon. It's just mostly what I feel right now is scared, excited, and surreal. I feel like it's really surreal that, I'm actually in Sunrise, Florida, and I'm actually gonna do this. And a tiny part of me is like, this is terrifying, what are you doing? And then I think, well, what will my alternative be? Staying how I am and not getting surgery? I don't think so. That would not make me feel very good. I think that this corresponds with a greater life goal of stepping outside of my comfort zone makes me feel like I'm alive. And that's what I'm doing. And I'm doing something that I know that I want, that is scary, but that I know will be okay, and I deeply hope will be fabulous. I think that's all for now. So, it is the night before surgery, July 11th, 2011. Surgery is tomorrow morning. They switched the time. It is tomorrow morning at 7:30 a.m. Early. I just got out of the shower. I had to cut off my necklace. I have all my other piercing things in place. And I had to shave. And I also had to shave my armpits. I just wanted to say that I thought that was really funny, that to do this really, you know, the most socially masculine thing I could do of getting top surgery, I had to do one of the most socially feminine things and shave my armpits, which I just thought was a little funny. I have a lot of feelings. I'm excited and also nervous just because it's a big thing to do, but I'm trying to move from nervous, anxious into grateful, excited, relieved, and I'm going to be brave. And my friend gave me an image that I'm surrounded in a golden ball of light and supported, and I like that a lot. And I'm going to be very brave and take this step because it's what I want, even if it's scary. The pre-op appointment was today. It went really well. Dr. Garramone is super nice. His staff is super nice, just like everyone says. He has a little more gray hair than I expected because I realized that I was referencing old videos of him. It was just really funny. But it was super easy, and I started getting excited and smiling a lot. And at first I was kind of shaking when I was filling out the paperwork. But as time went on, I got more excited and then went in to his office and saw the chair. I like to call it the chair because it's the chair that I've seen in like all the YouTube videos that are Dr. Garramone videos. And sat down, and he came in, and he introduced himself and shook my hand, and it was like really exciting to meet him finally. And he said, "So are you excited about tomorrow?" And I said, "Yes." I kind of forget what I said. I think it was a meaningful moment because I wasn't in completely excited mode yet, and I don't know if I am in that mode yet. I'm closer. But it was an interesting moment where I think he was expecting me to say, "Yes," you know, and I was just like, I don't even know what I said. I think I said, "Yes," and nervous, something like that. He went out and I put on a little like paper gown thing open in the front, and he came back with an assistant, and he measured my chest with a little tape measure and wrote measurements down and stood me in front of the mirror and pointed out where the new nipple placement will be and the sizing, and he said he will make it as symmetrical as possible, which I feel grateful for. And then I had my pictures taken without my face, and you know, put down the paper gown thingy and stood facing him, turned a little, turned to the side, then turned the other way, then to the side, and put my paper outfit back on, and then they left me to get dressed or put my binder and my shirt back on. Then my parents came in, and we all, and he came back in, and we all talked about any questions that we had, and I had tons of questions. And then it was time to go. It felt momentous. And then we went and picked up a whole bunch of stuff, including an antibiotic that he prescribed and a bunch of last minute things. Very real. It's very real. The idea of top surgery is exciting. The realness of top surgery is a little scary. And I'm not surprised, I'm just saying, and I know lots of people have expressed this before I have, but it's true. So yeah, I'm trying to be brave and put myself in the mindset of, this is what I want, because it is what I want, it's just scary, and I'll be excited to get to know my new chest and the good feelings that go along with that. I also spent a long time tonight going through all the medicine that I have to take and like organizing it so that my parents would know how to give it to me. Like so. And each one has its own like labeled spot on the table, and each one is numbered so that they know what to give me when. So I'm feeling pretty good about that. So all I'm trying to do now is do my deep breathing, think positively, think about the things that I'm excited about. I'm excited about being healed. I'm excited about not having to bind. I'm excited to feel good about part of my body. Picturing all the people that I know care about me and picturing them all kind of holding me up, you know, like surrounding me and holding me up. And that's an image that I really like. Actively, bravely take this step. So those are my thoughts the night before surgery. It is 1 a.m. I have to get up at 6. Yeah, I'm not doing a very good job of going to sleep. I'm gonna go. All right. goes down.
Standing in the shade all of my days, watch the sky breaking on the promise that
I had surgery on Tuesday morning with Dr. Garramone. The recovery has been a lot harder than I was anticipating, which I guess is kind of silly of me to not have thought about it more. I mean, I've had surgery twice before, so I thought I knew what I was in for, but this was a lot harder, and I should specify it's been a lot harder for me because of my stomach and sensitivity to pain medicine and what that does to my system, which I thought I was counteracting, but nay, not so, because my stomach sucks. And the other reason is that, for me, the bandage got really tight. That happened, I think, also because of my stomach and excess swelling and things like that. So it's just been a lot harder than I was anticipating, which sucks. I was really looking forward to, like, just relaxing and sleeping a lot and watching a bunch of movies and hanging out with my parents. And instead, it's been really hard. It was Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and half of today. 3.5 days were really, really hard, but I was able to get the bandage loosened twice, and that helped a lot, and I'm also changing my medicine around, so that should be better. But the actual surgery and everything was totally fine. So I got up that morning, and I was pretty nervous, but okay, and I just was like, okay, one foot in front of the other, let's do this. So I went to the hospital, filled out more forms, got taken into a room where I filled out more forms, came back, then a nurse called me in and took a bunch of information and then had me pee in a cup to make sure I wasn't pregnant, which I thought was funny, and then brought me back to the pre-op area where I was put into a, like, cubicle made out of drapes, you know, a bunch of people were all laying side by side and across from each other, so I had my own space. I put on the hospital gown and sat in the bed, and she came back and gave me a warm blanket, which was really nice. She put the IV in. It hurt. I knew it would. No big deal. The anesthesiologist came and we chatted, and that was all fine. And my parents came and stood/sat next to the bed for a little while. Then Dr. Garramone came and they went someplace else, and he was really, really, really nice and super friendly and comfortable and calm, because he does this 80 billion times a day, it seems like. And he got me out of bed and had me stand in front of him and tucked my hospital gown into my underwear so that he could see my chest. And he took a pen that was purple and in, like, a sealed, sterile plastic thing, like, opened it up and took out a pen, very hospital-like, and drew all the lines on my chest. He said to stand up as straight as I could and look forward, which I did. And then when he was done, he had me look down, and he explained what all the lines were and how he was going to do it. And he also drew on his glove. He drew a circle for the areola for the size he was going to make it, and a circle for the nipple for the size he was going to make it. And then he showed me the spots on my chest. When he was all done, he said, "That sound good?" And I was just, like, so excited and so happy and not scared at all in that moment. And I just went, "That sounds great." And I think he smiled, and it was really nice, and he was like, "All right." So he got me back in the bed and all set up, and my parents came back.